overview is the Thames London Science Park, which is linked to Reading University, just outside Reading, just off the M4 corridor. It has approximately 30,000 square feet of tree spaces, and the staircase is going to go inside the foyer to serve as a wow factor. That's next. So the initial design briefing with the client was to serve as the shops, cafes, and WCs within the science park. It's supposed to have the wow factor. It's got to have allow natural lighting, promote inspiration, and the initial brief was the width of the staircase was 1,200, but we'll put that up later on when I talk about it. The key values to our client for the staircase to inspire education, be exciting to look at, to be modern, so that's where we looked at different sorts of materials and also creative elements to the staircase as well.
So after we got our first brief, we then obviously decided to look for ideas. We started off with wooden staircases, but found out that it tended to be a bit dark. Seeing as we wanted natural lighting, we wanted to get it trying to opaque the surface to allow it fully through. To also help achieve this, we opted to go for a floating staircase to get rid of a lot of excess materials. Finally, we noticed that there was stairs with integral lights, which added more of a creative feel and also a bit intuitive. As I said, so we've opted to go for glass stairs, integral lighting in each stairs with a glass balustrade, brushed steel staircase supports, and we've opted for a 1600mm with a brushed steel handrail on either side. Central handrail is not needed for staircases over under 2 metres. That was our design we proposed to the client on the first meeting. Drawn to scale. Once we proposed that, we got given our final drawing from the client, which then dictated where and what stairs we could use.
Feasibility, we carried out a short 15-minute visual investigation. We used the staircase at Reading College because it's a similar environment. We'd expect it to have a similar sort of volume of people using it. The results were multiplied by 3 because obviously this is only one staircase. We're going to be building 3, so it just increased our accuracy. During peak times, we had 702 users on the stairs in the reception area and 225 people in off-peak times. This is shown on the pie chart below, so you can see that there's approximately a 3-to-1 sort of ratio between peak and off-peak times. We didn't find any issues from this study watching the use of it, the halfway landing, it was all fine and dandy. So it's a good foundation for us to develop our design off. As a business, this is a prime job for us, so it's central, easy to source labour. Our supply chain all works within the area. We've got experience in and are able to make use of and make profit on the job and offer value for money to the client as well. I'll talk through the costings on the next slide, but we expect to make just over £12,000 profit of a cost of just over £84,000 to the client. So it shows it's financially feasible for us. We also offer a 5% commercial discount to the client. If they're able to place an early order, to contact our supply chain and begin the off-site manufacturing process. This project's been engineered in a number of ways to increase the value for money for the client. It included market research into the materials that we were using, and I also spoke to a number of companies for different higher costs for our plant and scaffold. So I'll just kind of run over the costings. So as I said, it was £84,000 total cost with us making £12,500 profit. I broke it down into each item almost and the duration that will require things. I've also included for our plant, etc. Yeah, you can look at that in more detail if you wish to. Next, please. Quality, so to create the top quality staircases demand by today's market, CHLR incorporate a range of materials with many techniques and processes to manufacture premium quality products. Every operation is carried out under CHLR's externally audited quality control system with all components manufactured to order for the individual project. All materials are carefully sourced to ensure that they are of the required specification and quality and then allocated to the right project. We have always used manufacturer that has in-house quality control at all stages of the project. A staircase may contain as many as half a dozen different materials, each requiring different manufacturing techniques and operations. Therefore, we have our own in-house quality control team that have personally vetted all our supply chains to ensure that we only use top quality materials and workmanship.
So once we got our client drawing, we then made our final drawings. So the first staircase, which is at basement level, is 7.8 metres long by 4.4 high. To achieve the correct pitch of 33 degrees, we had to opt for 282 mm going and a rise of 183. Second one, it had slightly different measurements, which was 8.4 metres long by 4.6 high. To achieve the 33 degrees, we had to have 300 mm going by a 194 mm rise. This had the landing of 1.8 metres. And for our final one, we had to change the design of it and include a bit more steel. This was due to having no supporting wall on the second half of the staircase. To achieve this, as you can see in the overhead view of it, we had to use some more steel frame and a central steel beam going straight up into the landing above to still achieve that sort of floating effect on the staircase. And that's just... That's just an overview of what the treads will look like. It's got bolts every 400 centres with an LED strip going across the centre with an RGB lighting so you can change to whatever colour you'd like.
So the material specifications, going back to the initial client brief, having a wow factor, being modern and inspiration. So we chose to use toughened glass, a lot of natural light, also give it the photo reflect. Regarding to the open stair treads, obviously there's a hazard there for younger members of the public and children, so we had to put a clear PVC stair guard in. We chose PVC because it's clear, still allows us to have that natural light looking. One of the big things that Hugo touched on was the wow factor. Again, with the RVG system, depending on the time of year or anything going on in the venue, in the open space, in the forum area, you can change any colours you like, which is all mains power controlled by a separate box. And then obviously we had to do a bit more research into weight bearing of bolts and washers and stuff, and then that's why we chose the M16s for the warm up strings. Again, the landings were pretty much the same materials, again, with the addition of lots more tougher glass for the back as well.
Take our responsibilities under the Health and Safety at Work Act and under CDM 2015 very seriously. Therefore, we've taken into account that we will need to have welfare made available for all of our staff, direct employed staff, and our specialist subcontractors that will be working on site. The principal contractor has kindly offered us to use the main building to provide some of our toilet and washing facilities, a space for first aid, and a canteen for our staff so they've got somewhere to go and sit and take rest breaks or whatever. Regarding first aiders, because we'll be working on extended days, we'll always have two first aiders available so that we can make sure that at least two first aiders trained on the project to make sure we've got one available at least at all times. all our operatives, staff and subcontractors working on site will undergo the CHLR induction process, which goes through our specific risk and method statements. Our induction also includes our words. I'll come back to it in a minute. As a minimum, we will also require all staff on site to wear frequent PPE, that's the standard high-vis, safety boots, and a hard hat. However, if the risk assessment for the task they are undertaking requires them to wear additional PPE, such as gloves or safety goggles, then they must also wear this. Any operatives employed on the project will be fully qualified within their discipline. So if they are nuke drivers, they will have the correct licenses for that. If they are scaffolders, they will be correctly scaffold trained, supervisors, etc. And any visitors that come to the site, so if the client wishes to come to the site, you will also need to undergo the initial site induction and be required to wear the initial 3 points of PPE to ensure your safety whilst you're on the site. We will have an individual compound store to store all of our equipment and materials so they're kept away and they are locked away safely so they can't be tampered with. And there will be a traffic management plan in place, so there will be a route that people will drive around and clear pathways marked for pedestrians. So the site teams will all have staff adequately qualified in the following: CPCS appointed person for our lifting operations, MVQ level 3 controlling for lifting operations, CPCS slinger and signaller, PASMA, IPAF static boom 1B, IPAF powered access, vertical and mobile boom, site supervisor safety certificate, and all of our operatives will have CSCS cards. We will also have an SMTS qualified person on site. I'm still trying to remember what I wanted to go back to, but I can't, so apologies.
So I've tried to make the program as easy to read as possible. We agreed a 2-week program period with the client, so I've stuck my construction program within that 2-week bracket. I've got some initial pre-start work, such as around site visit, etc., happening obviously before the construction period. We're going to construct it from top to bottom, so this means that you're not going to be building the first string of stairs and then using it for access so it stays clean, untouched, etc. There is an overlap between once you finish the stair string, you'll then build, start constructing the balustrading and handrails. Whilst you're doing that, you can then start the next stair string. And yeah, all of that will lead us to completion within a 2-week time period.
The staircase has been designed to be inspirational, exciting, modern and creative, but functional with a wow factor. The glass and steel staircase with integral lighting design we have proposed will allow natural light to flood the atrium, be inspirational and provide the wow factor sought by the client. To fully comply with park care and building regulations, however, the following recommendations have been made. The staircase of 1600mm width with a handrail on either side, and dimensions of the stair treads have changed from the original specification. Sorry, there's not a word on the end of that. Okay, that's it. And then last bit is Q&A, so if anybody has any questions they'd like to ask any member of the team.
Any questions from the audience?
Why do you need site staff with a triple SDS and a SMS?
We just want to make sure we cover all bases so that if somebody has to have a day off, we've also got some cover to make sure that we are not left open should there be an incident.
And some clients prefer one or the other.